Simon instructed me with meticulous care.
Did he tell you what to expect?
Yes,
said Daniel, turning to him with amusement.
But I've so far encountered none of the things I was warned about. Simon spoke well of you, Master Brett, though he was less complimentary about the Lord Ralph.
Only because Ralph enjoyed poking fun at him.
I take such teasing in my stride. It's always good-humoured.
What else did Brother Simon say?
Daniel was discreet.
Enough to show that he didn't appreciate the privilege he was being given. I do appreciate it, Master Brett. Very much.
Let's see if you still feel that way at the end of our visit.
I've no doubts at all on that score.
He returned to his contemplation of the two graceful figures in front of him. They were 18 in number, wending their way at a steady trot through the Norfolk countryside. Six knights from Ralph Delchard's own retinue provided half of the escort, the remainder belonging to the new commissioner, Eustace Corton. Like their men, Ralph and Corton wore helm and hauberk and carried weapons. Gervase, too, though wearing the attire of a chancery clerk, had a sword in his scabbard and a dagger at his belt. Such a show of force was necessary on a journey that took them through six separate counties. Outlaws would think twice about trying to ambush such a well-defended group of travellers. Alert and disciplined, the soldiers rode in pairs. Sumpter horses followed on lead reins at the rear of the column. Leading the cavalcade were Ralph Delchard and Eustace Corton. Ralph had been pleased when his habitual colleague, Canon Hubert, was replaced by a veteran soldier. But Corton was not turning out to be the hardy warrior he had anticipated.